Amos, I got most of the horses secure and the chicken.
Well, thank you, Amos, but it's the herd I'm worried about.
I know. They're scattered all over the valley and beyond. The weather is coming in real fast.
So what do you suggest, Amos? We leave the herd out there to be scattered by the storm and ourselves left here to die without a livelihood?
Can I help?
No, miss. If the men get caught out in that storm, they're gonna die.
And if we lose our herd, we'll all die, you stupid man.
Doesn't sound like we're left with much of a choice then. Come on, Amos. Round up your men. Let's get the herd.
Dang.
Come on, boys. Let's get going before the weather gets any worse. That sky don't look good. I'm starting to think somebody up there is conspiring against me. Are you a religious man?
Not in any real sense. Sometimes I tell myself things happen for a reason. Like what brought me here was fate come a-calling. But nobody made my path for me.
We all need to look for answers somewhere. Some in big old books, others in big old bottles of whiskey.
Believing in some kind of divine purpose ain't gonna give me my wife and kid back. Pastor's who we are, Miss McFarland. There ain't no changing that. Faith is a luxury I can't afford.
We have two herds out grazing in different pastures. We'll need to merge them and bring them all back.
I think we can handle that.
The cows get real ornery in bad weather. It's more work, but I'll show you how to deal with them. We're not gonna be able to hear each other in this rain. Just make sure you don't lose sight of me. Easy now.
Thank you.
teacher one day.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
Excuse me, Mr. Marston. Have you seen my father anywhere?
No.
He went out this morning to ride the land and was supposed to be back hours ago. I don't know. The ranch hands have been out looking, but so far they found nothing.
Well, come on. Let's go look for him.
Come on. Let's see if we can find the old goat. Yee-up!
Let's go!
Feeling about this. It's not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarland. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got.
Don't you have any brothers or sisters, Miss McFarland?
I had six brothers, but five of them died, either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your pa.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust. Who's that over there? Easy now. Daddy, what happened?
Nothing nice. Wrestlers, I guess. Maybe the Baller twins, that bunch. Now you head back to the ranch right now and fetch your wagon.
Yes, sir.
Marston, you watch after her.
I'll do that, sir.
What could have happened to those poor men? And their horses were dead, too.
I think we should get back there as soon as we can.
Who could have done something like that?
Your pa seemed to have an idea who it was. Let's just do what he says and get the wagon.
Those damn rustlers! I've got a good mind to head over to Pike's Basin myself.
I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in. Like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have a code. Only some of us don't realize
it. The outlaw with the code? How wonderfully romantic. The reluctant murderer, the noble criminal. There's nothing more depressing than a man who's found a way to think the bad into good. Look, Mr. Marston, the barn is on fire.
Come on.
Come on!
Sure know how to handle yourself. Thanks, Marston.
Yes, John, thanks. You saved the ranch.
If you'll excuse me, I've got chores to attend to. Hey, hold on a second over there.
Sincerely, John, thank you.
Well, I did all I could, Miss McFarlane. Sorry about all the damage. That gang seems to really want you out of here.
Yeah, well, my father fought Indians. I scarcely think we're gonna be frightened by some white trash.
White trash can be pretty frightening.
Well, they don't frighten me.
Good.
John, my family owes you a great debt.
I think you got enough debt. You saved my life. All I ask of you is this. If I get back home and get my farm started back up, you'll sell me some cattle. I prefer doing business with people I know.
Of course, Mr. Marston. It'd be my pleasure. Well, you get some rest. I've got to go see how my father's bearing up.